walk in, we make sure that we leave our shoes right at the entrance. And so you start off with a grand foyer. First closet is typically a coat closet, but we do live in Florida, so I converted it into my cleaning closet. And this is where I store all of my candles, my vacuum accessories. I have my steam mop and vacuum hanging on the wall. And I do have my cedar mop here. And I always keep it with a little bit of water and detergent, so it's easy to do quick cleanups. Now as you enter, I have my full-length mirror here, and my kids absolutely love this mirror. And so I like to always keep a mirror in the entrance so you can always see yourself when you're leaving. And then I have this little console table. I keep one of my albums there. And just three simple candles in my wall art. You guys, a lot of this I already had in my previous home. Now another reason why I have my mirror in the direction that I do have it is it's facing right outside the bathroom. This is the guest bathroom, and here is where we keep our scale. I picked this little sign up in Big Lots. It was on clearance for $10, and I absolutely love the way it looks. This is the guest bathroom. Nothing a big deal about it. It's a nice size. It's not too small. In Miami, I think the bathrooms are smaller, so this is a nice size. And so I have their hamper here, and I also keep hooks behind the door so they can hang up their towels. And everything is very simple, you guys, very clean. I don't like to have a lot of things up on the counter. And I have my little sign, which I love and I've had for a while. I think I picked this up in Ross. And my little starburst here. And you're gonna see my leaner mirror, which I hung. I'm gonna turn that fan off. Sorry about the noise, you guys. Anyways, this is the mirror where you can come out of the bathroom, see how you look after you've taken a shower. And off to the left is going to be the guest bedroom slash my mom's bedroom. She's the one who stays here the most with us. We do have a lot of guests coming, you guys. I feel like every week or every other week we have people over, which I absolutely love, and I am not complaining. But this is the guest bedroom, and I did show you guys how I made that. I'll go ahead and link the video below. The only new addition here is this little pillow here, and basically it just says me plus travel equals happy. And that is the theme of the guest bedroom. It is traveling. So I have these boxes, and I show you guys all of this and my train of thought when I designed this. And I think this is also new. I don't think you guys have seen this. My mom picked this up in Tuesday morning, and she absolutely loves it. You guys, you're gonna hear this a lot during this video, because the key thing is that we only have things that we absolutely love. We're kind of a minimalist, elegant, modern, glam look is what I like to go with. It's definitely my style. And I'm gonna give you one last glimpse of the guest bedroom. I wanna get something for the top here, but I still haven't found what I'm looking for. So that is that. And I'm gonna move slowly so I don't get you guys dizzy. This room is my daughter's room. My daughter and my son have asked me to please keep their rooms private. So I'm gonna go ahead and respect that. If that changes at a later date, I will let you guys know for sure. So this entryway is pretty long, and it also has another closet, which is the linen closet. I'm actually washing towels right now. That's where the towels will go. And I only keep 6 towels, you guys. And these are just a couple of extra blankets, because we do keep the house cold. And so sometimes my guests ask me for those kinds of things. So I want to make sure I have it handy. Here's my extra detergent and softener. And for right now, I'm keeping these little pool noodles here because we do use them quite often on the weekends. We'll tend to go to the springs. And so this, guys, is a nice large opening. I don't know if the camera's picking it up right or not, but the foyer and the opening is pretty large. The house is very different from our previous houses. Usually the previous houses has the living room in the front and the bedrooms to the back, but in this case it is the opposite. And I'm gonna show you why. So this is just the garage, and I'm still working on that. We did a pretty good clean out this past week, but there are some things that I still wanna do before I show you guys that. This is the AC, and it's a pretty large room. Has a lot of storage. I don't keep anything in here except for the extra filters, and that I picked up on Amazon because this is a carrier and Home Depot and other stores do not carry this. But you know, some people might use that to store things. I like to keep it nice and open. And turning right back around, sorry if you guys got dizzy. This is my son's room, which I'm not gonna show again because he asked me for some privacy. And this is the laundry, you guys. I showed you this room. I did the makeover specifically for this home tour. I wanna make sure that it's being focused here. So my mom got me this little laundry sign, which is so adorable, and I wanted to add a reef and add the sign, but I haven't found anything that I like yet as for the reef, because I want it to be kind of on the greener side. This door typically stays open unless, you know, it gets messy in there, but that doesn't happen very often. And so again, I'll go ahead and link that video down below. I show you guys how I made this banner, and I also show you guys how I did those signs. I keep my ironing board here. On the laundry video, I showed you guys that I hung it behind the door, but it was just taking up too much space and the door wasn't opening all the way, and I don't like that. So I just went ahead and stood it right there. And so moving along, now this is the other side of the house. This is the actual kitchen. It's very, very comfortable. It has a lot of cabinets and it has a nice island. This is still my summer decor, you guys. This is gonna start coming down this week, because the first week of September, I am definitely gonna start with my fall decor and the crafting. So make sure you subscribe so that you can see all of my crafts coming up, my DIYs, and fall decor. Definitely gonna have a house tour for that as well. Wanted to show you guys this sign right here. And I picked that up in Big Lots with the other sign. I absolutely love this sign, you guys. So I had to put it somewhere where I wanted to display. And so this is my pantry. Here I'm gonna have a reef. And I do wanna put a sign up here, and I'm going to decorate all up here. So those are things and videos that I'm gonna be bringing to you guys. This is my pantry. I absolutely love my pantry, you guys. I've never had one. So this to me is amazing. And I show you guys how I organize and redid this space. This is real life. This is how it looks on a regular basis, you guys. I will link below the video where I redid it and I take you step by step. And so this is real life. This is not staged. This is what my pantry looks like on a daily basis. I have my dog food here. And you guys, we have a lot of water because we do have a storm coming, Tropical Storm Dorian. And you never know how those things go. So you wanna make sure that, just prepared, make sure we have a little bit of water and food. And that's it. And so we're moving on over here. I'm gonna show you guys my fridge really quick while it's clean. And I showed you guys this on my video, or you're gonna see it in my cleaning video coming up next. So super happy how everything came out, super organized, which I love. That makes me so happy. And this, you guys, is my coffee station. I am gonna do a kitchen tour where I'm gonna open all my cabinets, show you where I have everything. This looks like it kind of fell here. There you go. So I'm gonna be opening all of my cabinets and showing you my organization. But for right now, this is going to be my coffee station. I just set this up really quick, but I am gonna be working on this and getting it ready for the fall season. I absolutely love this sign. I picked that up from Ross for $5.99. And I just thought it would be so cute and go with my theme. And so right next to my coffee station is my dining room. And this is an open concept, you guys. I love this style of home. Most of my homes have always been open concept. I really enjoy it. And I like to be able to entertain, cook, and be able to see my guests when they're over, or my family. You guys, I'm so sorry about the lighting. It is dark outside. It looks like it's gonna be storming, which it's basically every day. We're getting a thunderstorm. So, kind of not good. Anyways, this is my living room. I have my angel wings from Z Gallery, my weenie bed, my little dog, my weenie dog, her little bed, so we call it the weenie bed, is tucked in right there. And these sofas are from Rooms to Go. It is a Cindy Crawford edition. And this is how I have my coffee table set up right now for the summer. I have another little weenie dog. And I have pictures of my fur baby there. And my daughter and my soon-to-be son-in-law. And my daughter and son, which she was telling me she has a better picture. So I'm gonna be changing that out. And you guys have seen this in my previous video. And I'll go ahead and link those as well down below. Let me see if my camera wants to focus, you guys. I have an amazing, amazing view, even though right now it's cloudy, as you can see. I actually have a lake right behind us with a beautiful waterfall, and it is stunning at night when it goes a little bit darker. The waterfall does light up. And so I'm gonna go ahead and take you guys outside where we keep our barbecue. I will also link the video. You guys are gonna get foggy because it's really cold in my house and it's nice and humid. Anyway, I'll go ahead and link my backyard tour. I also showed you guys that as soon as I moved in. The only changes are these pillows here. You guys, I am so sorry. My camera just got so foggy right now. And I think I showed you guys this as well in that video of my backyard. So we're right next to a preserve, which is a forest, and we see all kinds of neat animals, including deer, back here, so that's pretty interesting. And so moving back on in. Hey, look who woke up! Look who woke up!
And this is the master bedroom. You guys, I lost some of my footage, but I wanted to make sure that you were able to see everything, and it finally cleared up. So I'm super, super happy that the sunshine is coming through. And with this, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and end the video with just the last clips of my master bathroom. And remember to subscribe. I have other videos coming up soon. I have a clean with me coming up next, and then we're going to start the fall decorating and the fall season, you guys. And I'm definitely going to have a fall house tour as well. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, loves. Mwah.